Hello friends, welcome back. And we are covering the number system series, right? So what are the topics that we have already covered? That what is decimal number system, then what is the binary number system, and uses of binary number system, and what is face value, positional value, and the place value. These are the topics that we have already covered in the previous videos. All right. So today we will see the octal number system, and in today's session we will cover what is octal number system, then we will see the what is face value, positional value, and the place value with the help of one example, and then we will see the uses of octal number system. Okay, so what is octal number system? Basically, the base or the radix for octal number system is 8. Okay, and the octal number system is a number system which uses 8 digits to represent any number, and these digits are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And there are no numbers or letters used above 8. All right. And it is a positional number system. Okay, means same as a decimal and binary number system, right? So the octal number system is a positional number system, same like decimal and binary number system. In decimal number system, the positional value increases in the powers of 10. And in binary number system, the positional value increases in the powers of 2. Okay, so in the same way, the octal number system uses the powers of 8. Means each octal digit has its own positional value, which increases in powers of 8 starting from right. Okay. And we will try to understand in a detailed way in the next example. So let us understand with the help of one example. Suppose we have a number called 245. Okay. So one more thing that we need to understand here, that if we are writing any number, then it is compulsory to write the base of a number system, right? If we will not write the base of a number system, then we cannot identify that whether this particular number belongs to which base, right? Suppose if we have written like 245, we have not mentioned the base, then we cannot say that whether it is an octal number or the decimal number system. Okay, so here it is an octal number, so we will write its base as 8. All right, so again we will see the face value, positional value, and the place value that I have already mentioned in the binary number system and the decimal number system in the previous videos. Okay, once again we will revise all these terms here. Okay, so in the first row we will write the digits, that is 2, 4, and 5. Now, in the second row, we will mention the face value. So, face value is the value of the digit itself, or the actual value of a digit is called its face value. Alright. So, here the face value of 5 would be 5, for 4 would be 4, and for 2 would be 2. Now, come to the next point, that is positional value. For getting the positional value, we will write down the position of all the digits starting from the right. Okay, so first, second, and third means we are starting from the right. So for first digit it would be 1, for second digit it would be 2, and for the third digit it would be 3. Now we will calculate the positional value. Once again we will write the formula that base to the power x minus 1, here base is 8 and x would be the position of a digit. Okay, so positional value for the first digit would be a to the power 1 minus 0, that is a to the power 0, or you can say 1. Now come to the second digit, that is 4. The positional value would be the a to the power 2 minus 1, that is 1, means a to the power 1, or simply you can say 8. Now come to the next digit, that is 2. So for this the positional value would be a to the power 3 minus 1, that is a to the power 2, or you can say 64. Alright, now come to the place value. So each digit has a value based on its position called the place value, right? Or if we multiply the face value to its positional value, then we will get the place value. Now again, starting from the right hand side, for digit 5 it would be 5, because 5 into 1 would be 5. Then for the second digit it would be 4 into 8 equals to 32, and for the third digit it would be 2 into 64 equals to 128. Alright, so these are the place values for the individual digits. Alright, and if we'll add these place values, like 128 plus 32 plus 5 is equals to 165, then 165 would be the decimal equivalent of the octal number 245. Okay, so by this table I am just explaining the face value, positional value and the place value. Okay, and conversion and all these topics we will cover in detail in the coming sessions. So here we show the table which shows the decimal and the binary equivalent of 8 octal digits. In the first column we will see the octal digits starting from 0 to 7, and in the second column we can see the decimal value. Again we'll see from 0 to 7, and in the third column we can see the 3-bit binary number. Or you can say that this binary number is equivalent to the given octal digit in the table. Okay, so some more points that we will cover, like in octal number system base is 8, so every symbol of this system can be represented by its 3-bit binary equivalent. Why 3? See, in octal we have base 8 and in binary the base is 2. So 2 ki power kya kare ki humko 8 milega? 2 to the power 3, right? So that is why 3-bit binary equivalent means 3 binary digits are sufficient to represent any octal digit. Again we will understand this with the help of one example. Suppose we have a binary string, right? So this is a binary, so we will write 2 as its base, and what we will do, we will group the digits into basically we will divide these digits in the group of 3-3, right? So what, how many groups we can find? 0-1-0 is the one group, then 0-0-2 another group, then 1-0-1, then 1-0-0, right? So we're starting from the right hand side. 0-1-0 in the table, 0-1-0 in the table is equals to 2, so we will write it down as 2. Now 0-0-1, 0-0-1 is equals to 1, so again we will write it down 1, then 1-0-1, 1-0-1 is equals to 5, so we will write as 5, then 1-0-0, 1-0-0 is equals to 4, so we will write as 4. So the number which we got, 4-5-1-2. What is this exactly? Basically this is the octal equivalent of the given binary number. Alright, so by this way we can convert the octal number system into a binary number system into a octal number system. So come to the next topic, that is the uses of octal number system. So first is a compact representation of the binary numbers. See, with the increase in the value of a binary number, the number of bits, that is 0 and 1 in its binary representation, also increases. And sometimes a binary number becomes so large that it becomes difficult to manage. That is why the octal number system came into the picture for the compact representation of binary number. Alright, and hence it reduces the chances of errors, because less number of digits means less chances of errors. Okay, then easily conversion in binary. As we know and we have seen in the last video, that the computer understands only binary number system, means the language of 0 and 1. So conversion from octal to binary means octal to binary and binary to octal is quite simple as compared to other conversions. Okay, so that is why this number system is used. Okay, so in short we can say that octal number system are used by the computers. So that's all for today's session. Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe, like and share if you like it. Thank you.